BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
From Nostock, the Hidden Valley.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Nostock Festival. The band made more noise than you. Anyway, we need to see if there's a doctor in the house. We may need one for this next group. I'm told that the lead singer is about 20, but has got the body of a 70-year-old caused through extensive gigging. You may also need a doctor because by the end of the first song, he's probably burst every blood vessel in his face. They're all actively involved in the planning of the Worcester Music Festival as well, so some great guys on the local music scene. They're Johnny P, Dambo, Pedro and Mick. I hope they're gonna teach you the robot dance this afternoon. They're called Calm Like a Riot. Now, I will point out that Andy O'Hare, who's sitting over there on that cable drum, discovered these guys. He thought that this four-piece were actually called something completely different, okay? So for those of you who don't know them as Calm Like a Riot, here's Andy O'Hare's favourite four-piece, Carl, Mike and Ryan.
It's daytime, but if you want to get your lighters on, this is where it's going to get heavy. Like a ball in a china shop, when I rock the hip-hop with a fat green crop, I won't stop until I drop off the face of the earth, off a thirst for reverse. Can't be quenched by the trickle in the curses. I keep it right, keep it tight, ripping the mic with inside 90 explosives. I'm prepared to fight. Keep my mind right so I can write what comes into it. When I flip the scripts, you can feel the heat and the spirit. I want all four elements in my toolkit. Live it, love it, believe it. Not the gangster, I want to be the rhyme slayer. Combining the rhymes and become the wall sprayer. Breaking like a drop is something loud. Helping me to move the crowd. I'm popping, breaking like a drop is something loud. Helping me to move the crowd because I gotta. Meaningless statements. The underground pouncer be on the pavement. Wake up, kids. See, it's not about the blame. It's about the rhyme skill. Love doing the thing. Leave the loop to the prostitute to the pimp. Don't be blinded. Be the grinder, not the chimp. Live on the stage because I just stub my toe. Where the song goes, nobody knows where it goes. And it grows like a scroll. It's all right. Now you know why I wear shades when I write. Because it goes like a scroll. It's all right. And now you know why I wear shades when I write. Because I got it.
Gotta get out.
Get people moving. I gotta get up. I gotta get out.
Out, you free.
Get people moving. I gotta get up. I gotta get out.
Gotta get out.
Get people moving. I gotta get up. Gotta get out.
Out, you free.
Get people moving.
Gotta get out.
Get people moving. We got to get out, get people, something to shout them out. We got to get up, we got to get out, we got to get those people moving. Now I set up the box, trap the shrapnel from the rap attack, front to the back, no one can relax. Get tapped out, like a target on the rifle range, step back and get slapped by the deranged madman. Had them to the top of the list, head is missed, as quick disappearing to the mist, not to be missed. Delivering oblivion, hack on the tongue of a generation. Don't understand the movement, they're not hip to the hop. When the abuse of the music go into stop. Drop the attitude, replace it with aptitude. Get people in the move, put the needle on the groove. It's about the skill, that's what's ill. Give me the beat, watch the vibe get killed. It's about the skills, that's what's ill. Give me the beat, I watch the rhyme get killed. And I gotta
get out.
Thanks very much. This next song, I'd like to do a personal thank you to Hereford and Worcester. Not the introducing stuff, we'll get onto that in a minute. But my personal thank you is to Howard Bentham and Tony McDonald for waking me up in the morning. This song's for you. I hope you play it in the morning. And it's called Tell Me Where the Beat Goes.
discontent. Wonder where the hell the last century went. The government's not listening. I criticise and realise most of my aggression's gonna be better spent. Things with no content for intelligent discourse. We swallow it all, though of course we're forced. Now I'm fallen, I'm fed up of everyone else's creative input. And I pull my foot down, draw a line on the door. I can rock the run, this right on time, but I can't ride the overture. I'm overdue in order to promote a focus on text from the cloud, not loud enough to rhyme home. This isn't a joke. Then a voice in my head spoke and said, tell me where the beat goes. Tell me where the beat goes. Now tell me where the beat goes. As usual, what happens on these kinds of occasions? I wake up on the floor of the pub or in the pavement, still feeling bad, not knowing what is happening. Battling to remember any possible arrangements. I might have made and straight to the point. The point is I'm in the pub, but the drink is inside. Couple of zips and a frown is eclipsed by a smile on my lips. Here's a tip, never trip before, never try at all. It's hard time, I climb to this self-imposed wall. Barrier barring me from forward motion. Notion I should start with some self-promotion. Quickly replace my idea of starting a commotion. Tell me where the beat goes. Tell me where the beat goes. Now tell me where the beat goes. Tell me where the beat goes. Tell me where the beat goes. Of the lost point, scout on cloud, tumbling to the world, putting ourselves a bow, shout out to my dog, and it jumps to its guns. Love to my flow when I see the crowd jump. I jump round the stage like 70, razor blinding me, and I roar like a dandelion kill. My need to succeed is appealing to still. So, just move even around, turn around, turn around, relentless. Don't drop it into its containers, prevent us. Now you're going by the express where we reach the top of some smell of rose, and the bubble drop. Fire, fire, and fire, we fire, we perspire, we aspire.
Coverage of our local festivals.
Live from Nostock.
BBC, introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
So calm like a riot. Well played on stage today. I can see why Andy thought you were Carl, because actually the way you were arranged on stage actually spelled out Carl.
He's one of our uncles. Uncle Carl. You know, we like to give him props every time we can. Okay.
Did you get the order right then, was it?
No. C-A-R-L.
Really?
Yes. we did more than Danny Boyle did for the Olympic starts to try and get this right, and we still failed.
Could have been worse starting with a C. You could have spent anything, couldn't you?
Yeah,
get away with that.
It's a family show, lads.
Sorry.
Keep it out.
How was the gig?
I had a great time. I don't know about you.
We loved it.
Who cares what the crowd thought? I had a fantastic time.
Perhaps should have some people watching it. That might be might get a more true reflection.
We'll do that in a bit.
Okay.
We'll see what they...
We're not interested in any critical feedback.
That's Please, we were rubbish.
Do you want me to cut it from the
edit it well, Andy? We know you can.
We're ruinous.
What's the biggest form of criticism you've ever had?
Oh, my mum said once that we were too loud.
My mum and dad once walked out on us, didn't they?
Oh, that's
halfway
really?
Through the first song.
Yeah.
Were they were offended or just didn't like the music?
First swear word, drop the C-bomb, and that was it, your mum was...
You just said breast. That's enough for my mum and dad.
Right, OK. So they've now gone from the interview because you've dropped the word again.
Oh, yeah.
So there we are then. Now, no longer listeners to Howard Bentham at breakfast.
I mean, he gets me up every morning. I'd like to say that now. Howard Bentham, Tony McDonald, thanks very much for just talking your talk on the radio. I mean, I'm just hoping he plays our song. That's all I care
He'll
about.
If Howard Bentham woke me up in the morning, I'd be worried.
Every morning he's by my bedside, just like, get up, John.
So what's the odds on him playing one of our songs in the morning?
Zero, because it's a non-music show.
Oh, yeah, good point.
No, thanks for this silly little point, but doesn't seem to matter.
Forget everything I said on stage.
What's the future with Calm Like a Riot then?
Oh, we'll just keep doing what we're doing.
Yeah, just keep plugging away. Gradually, hopefully get some slightly bigger gigs like this. A couple of weeks ago, we played a wedding. That was good.
Yeah, we played an 11-year-old rugby party.
Did you swear there?
Well,
did the kids swear more?
Yeah, I was going to say they had better swear words than me.
You learned a lot.
I put a lot into my songs.
Now, was the robot song the bride and groom's first dance?
Oh, we wish. Oh, wish. I walked backwards up the aisle. Awesome, isn't it? Brilliant. No, unfortunately.
Yeah, we always lean to try and get as many people doing the robot dance at the moment. The world record is 52. So if anybody comes
today,
to see us.
Today it was
zero.
Well, it was one really low looking dude, didn't she?
Yeah, one little girl.
It's difficult on a festival after everyone's got like a hangover and it's a Sunday.
I saw about three guys struggling to walk forwards, let alone back. Boom! He's gone again.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
From Nostock, the Hidden Valley.
Okay, who wants to dance? Yes! Come on, it's sunny, some music on and stuff. This is our dance song. You come up on stage and dance if you want. Hoax, fancy a spell?
Hang on a minute.
Is he awake?
Harry from the Worcester have checked us out and they put us on this stage. So thanks very much to them. Thanks to the two Andes. This song's the one that I hate, but they love. So this song's called The Robot Song.
Gonna get that robot effect on my voice, yeah?
Okay, that's it. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. Woo! I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards.
Woo! Stop! Look over there, a robot walking backwards. Crazy things into the bill. Is it after us? I don't think so. Walking in reverse is a sign of peace. So worthy of this humanical mechanical inspiration. Beam down from a robot nation. If I'm not mistaken, cause Jason who said that. He's amazing. What do we do to raise our glasses, phone the relations? Push a robot, walk back to creation.
I'm a robot, I'm walking.
Anybody can do it, it's easy.
I'm a robot, I'm walking.
Any of you.
I'm a robot, I'm walking.
Woo, woo, woo! This robot with moves so fine. Is it a mind? Is it a sign? A sign of what? A higher power?
Let's fall back on the hour.
The amazing man of metal could change the world. Except he's powered by petrol.
I'm a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards. I am a robot, I'm walking backwards.
Woo! Is there anybody from IT here? It seems to have stopped working. He stopped beeping, whirring and reversing. Now I've tried hitting him, I've tried cursing him, but then, well, what do you think I did? I turned him off and on again. The IT crowd here seemed to work and the robot said,
I am a robot, I'm walking backwards, I am a robot.
voice in my head says, John, think of this in the voice, longevity, legacy. He's getting me, so I'll get me a plan and I'll put to the paper, get my mates to follow the lead. Talk about his amazing feat, and his amazing feat. You know, once he stopped an earthquake,
no.
He made rain in the desert. Ooh. This food measure, he's got it in spades. He's cured the whole world of AIDS. His story's starting to follow his girl when the truth is great. Nobody knows, he's a legend. The books are selling, it's a little bit made up, but it talks about disgust. On TV shows, in newspaper, because they've written down, they believe it's the truth.
So we're supporting the Proclaimers, that's what we're putting on our website now we've done this gig. Supporting the Proclaimers, come on! Yeah. How far have they come?
They've
come a long way.
They have come a long way. 500 miles?
I think it's 500 more than that, mate.
This is our last song, it's called Pat Cash. Oh, and when the bass comes out, it's like this. Money doesn't make a man, funny that you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. Money doesn't make a man, funny that you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. Yeah. You know those actors, those gun clappers, those rappers. Yeah, well, they're talking about change, running about change. That's the change from the notes, they're deranged. They remain the same. If you think success is what you're making, might find me broke, but you won't find me faking. You're mistaken if you think I'll be overtaken. Anyone who thinks what they're driving is just pay is simple. I'm too nimble. We won't go, there's not enough room in the top. Room for my ego. Flow's incredible, not edible, no write it. Try and recite this. End up fumbling, tumbling into blindness. You're mindless if you think that I'm crumbling. When I say, money doesn't make a man, funny that you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. But don't get de-stressed or depressed, cause I'm here to put your mind at rest. Cause I am what I am and what I am. I'm Candace, disappointed, reversing to the doormat. Don't think that I'll make you stand back. The walls of your house, watching fall to the floor. You can't ignore the way I spray. I remain hardcore, no hardcore, no repeat. I spit to the beat, I keep it neat. So fools can't compete, it makes me complete. Not the holes on the deck, check the way that I grow. Blow up and set the metal set. If you can't do what I do, it is complicated, but it's so original. The pinnacle of what I do flows through me. Not as in the gun of anyone who thinks cash funny.
Money doesn't make a man funny.
Money doesn't make a man funny. Don't concentrate on the trappings of the next man. You'll end up next man. I've seen the future. It's not bright. If you're not content with your lot in your life, and if you're not, then why not do something about it? If you can't have it, then you go without it. Don't count every second, mate. Every second go. No amount of wealth can bring you back to life. Count to live the way that we're taught to live. Get a job, wife, mortgage, house, and kids. You will rack up the debt. They'll get upset, cause they can't have everything to blame. Blind if I'm not flying in the way. I pray, I sing. Money doesn't make a man funny, don't you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. Money doesn't make a man funny, don't you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. Money doesn't make a man funny, don't you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. Money doesn't make a man funny, don't you give a damn. Money doesn't make a man. That's the way I will smash. Let's make it simple. I'll smash. Let's make it simple. I'll smash. Let's make it simple. I'll smash. Their status symbol.
Thank you very much, Nostock! Choreography there, choreography.
They're one of the most political and one of the most offensive groups we've ever discovered. So if you're listening to this on the radio, good, it means we've also got a job. Ladies and gentlemen, calm like a riot! And if we're not here next Friday from 7, it's been a real pleasure.
This week's exclusive performance.
Live from Nostock.
BBC, introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
What's your name, where you from?
Hugh from Bridgend, South Wales. Yeah, quite good. Yeah, enjoyed them.
Yeah, really good. It's interesting, different.
Who have you come to see this weekend?
Andy C, but I missed him because I was drunk. Yeah, they were good. They were really good. I liked him. He was crazy.
Duncan from Worcester. I've come to see Calm Like a Riot. They were really good. I really enjoyed them. They were brilliant.
My name's Danny May and I'm from Worcester.
I don't know if you come to see this weekend, Dad.
Lots of stuff. The Futureheads, Correspondents.
Hello, my name's Mark and I'm from Worcester.
Who have you come to see this weekend?
I've come to see you, Andy.
Anybody else?
Yeah, there's lots of people playing today. Calm Like a Riot, Wooden Horse, Rhea, who's on now. Yesterday, the Futureheads were brilliant. Sick Note were brilliant. I missed Friday. I wanted to see Johnny Kowalski.
Oh, I saw him on Friday. He was brilliant.
Was he? I heard he rocked the place.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
From Nostock, the Hidden Valley.
So here we are. It's the Sunday evening. No sign of the Proclaimers yet, but they are on a little bit later on. I'm here with Ella Nosworthy, the person who's got her name to the farm and her name to the festival itself. You probably remember this growing up as a kid, do you? And your dad kind of organising this, and now you're in the driving seat very much yourself.
Yeah, I do actually. I was thinking the other day, I don't really remember a time when Nostock wasn't around, to be honest. So yeah, I mean, I've seen it grow over the years and I have got more involved, and I think that's a good thing because as it's grown, it's more than one person can do. And you know, but it's developed, it's changed, and I think all the changes have been for the better.
When we caught up with you in the week, you were planning for this. The weather's turned out all right.
Yeah.
What about ticket sales? Do you know yet?
I don't know exactly yet. No, I've been running around doing all sorts. I've been crazy busy. But, you know, there's a lot of people here. People are having fun. It seems to have gone really, really well. The sun's been shining and you can't ask for more than that.
Your dad was the first on the phone when the Big Chill cancelled, saying, hang on a minute, we're now the largest outdoor music festival in Herefordshire and indeed the two counties. Did the Olympics play a part for you? Because that was their excuse. What about yours?
Well, I think we're two different crowds anyway, so, you know, I don't know how much of a difference it made. Yeah, the Olympics has been an issue. Some of our bands have been there as well, but I think ultimately we're a different crowd. You know, and whatever, the show's going to go on with us. We just like doing it too much.
You said you weren't going to see any bands, but you might get a bit of comedy because you're always so busy when you're putting a festival on. Have you seen anyone?
Yeah, well, there's been quite a few funny moments with the crew. And, of course, we had two guys that tried to break in and our bull chased them up a tree. So they rang the police because they couldn't get down. And the police had to ring us to say, can you come and get these two guys down from one of your trees? So that was quite funny. That's our new security team, is Bacon the Bull. But yeah, I mean, I'm nearly finished now. Hopefully I will get a cider and catch the Proclaimers tonight.
So what's your typical day then when the festival's on? What do you do?
Run around a lot.
Okay.
Whatever needs doing, really. Get up and sorting the bands out when they're arriving, picking them up, taking them to a hotel maybe, finding an ironing board.
Really?
Yeah, whatever needs to be found. Running up and down, checking all the area managers are okay, looking for leads, just whatever needs doing, really. The nature of running an event is just, it's all organised chaos.
And when things go wrong, do they truly go wrong?
Sometimes. Right. We did have someone that tried to go to the toilet on an electric cable and nearly shorted something, but we managed
they
to
soon
stop
noticed.
That. Yeah, we managed to stop that just in time. No, I think it's all gone really, really well. I mean, feedback's been good, everyone's been having a good time, and the more we've done it, the more organised we've got and the more used to our job we are, so it's not the same stressful thing it used to be. Now we try and have fun with it.
It's good to see the sun shining, it's good to see you smiling as well.
Yes.
So many times have I seen Nos with his head in his hand saying, I've lost lots of money once again because of the rain.
The rain, the infernal rain. It was a worry this year. I mean, on Wednesday we still haven't got the bales off the field. And, you know, the ground's a bit squidgy, but ultimately that's just made it good for putting tents up. And certain people quite enjoy it when it's raining. You know, you get your wellies on, you have a party in the mud. Dad's just a pessimist by nature.
Okay. But this could be a festival which suddenly makes some money, is it?
I don't know about that. I mean, obviously we lost so much money in previous years that if we do make money this year, it's only paying off previous years. So I'm not running, skipping anywhere.
So if you've always been losing money, what keeps you doing it? I'm back to ask.
I know, we're crazy, aren't we? We love it. It sounds ridiculous. And yeah, we have lost money, but the feedback that you get from people when they say they love it and they come up to you and they're like, thank you for doing this, it's just such a nice feeling. It makes it all worth it. I always feel so cheesy when I say that, but it's the absolute truth. And how many people can say that they run a festival for a living? We love it.
And it's better in the farming?
Oh, yeah. Who wants to get up at 6.30 in the morning to look after the cows? I'd rather get up at 6.30 in the morning to go and meet a band. Thank you very much.
This week's exclusive performance.
Live from Nostock.
BBC, introducing in Hereford and Worcester.